honor for me too. I would like to introduce our next speakers. Johan Grau is the Vice President of Inner Space Explorers. Kevin Mixed Gas Diver and Instructor, and his passion is wreck diving. And Mr. Rasmus Duher, he's the most active instructor of Inner Space Explorers, Director of PADI course, Kevin Mixed Gas Instructor, and the future instructor and trainer of Inner Space Explorer.
So, first of all, we want to say good morning to all of you. It's nice that you are interested in our training education organization. The first thing I want to know from you, who of you is a professional diver? That means instructor, dive master, something like that. Okay, and who of you is a mixed gas or cave diver, technical diver? Oh, fine. Good. Elvis, could you go on?
Yes, sure.
So, just about ISE. What was the idea to found ISE? In general, there are a lot of training agencies, and you can think that it is not necessary to create another agency for training. But if you are an instructor by yourself and you take a look at all the students you had and students you saw while you were diving in other places of the world, you often saw students where you think, oh, that's not the perfect way of diving. You should do this other. Other training agencies had standards where you say, okay, I cannot move, I cannot change, I have to fix these standards and I will do it other. And this was the reason for saying, okay, just set up a new agency where we define new standards, where we have a higher level on education, and where we can produce students, not as a mass production, but where we can produce students with a high quality and a high security on diving. At ISE, we have several categories of diving. We have cave diving, mixed gas diving, retriever diving, and since the boat show of this year in Düsseldorf, we have also recreational education. All of these training categories can be done in different configurations. We have the standard back mount configuration where you have your tank or your double tank and your stage tanks with you. And you also can do your dives with a side mount configuration or with a CCR configuration. The most important thing for all of the technical diving classes are the fundamentals. If you want to go in the depth, you have to be able to dive in the shallow water. You have to practice and you have to perform a good ascent, you have to have a good trim and buoyancy, and therefore we have the BOE class. You can see here, the big one, the basic of exploration. Maybe Rasmus can talk about our different classes and can inform you about what he's educating while he's doing these classes.
Thank you, Jochen. I'm Rasmus, I'm coming from Denmark and got this fantastic opportunity to speak here today. I'm sorry I don't like the mic, so I'm gonna scream to you instead. I hope that's okay. If you can't hear me back there, please feel free to come up here. Anyway, as Jochen said, Inner Space Explorers is just another training organization in the mass of training organization, or is it? It differs a lot within the philosophy of training. And as Jochen also said, the BOE Basics of Exploration class is the fundamental of all the other classes. So no matter what you have to do, except for a few workshops you see in the top, you have to start to do the basics of exploration. And that actually doesn't matter even if you are a dive master or instructor, or if you're technical certified from another agency. So why is this? It's because all the classes within Inner Space Explorers is based on the basics of exploration. I taught quite a few basics of explorations already, and I had instructors on the most of the classes, and I had technical divers on the most of the classes. I also had quite new divers, and even the new diver with 60, 70 dives in the logbook, or a technical diver with 500, 600 dives in the logbook, they're all struggling on this class. Not because we're gonna hammer you with a lot of different stuff, but because we're gonna teach you at the level you are at. You're gonna know how to back swim, back kick, whatever you wanna call it, helicopter turns. You have to get a perfect trim, and your buoyancy will be the best when you come out of this class. So that's the fundamentals of all the training we have. We cannot take you on to a cave class or a technical class if you do not have these fundamentals. So that's why we start at the basic of exploration. If you think you have these skills already, we can do assessment with you. You can spend a day with Spyros here in Greece, and he can say, okay, you are a really good and experienced diver, so you just need to know the knowledge and how we think in Inner Space Explorers, and that's why you have to do still the basics of exploration, maybe not a full class, but you have to know the basics of it. Does that make sense? Yes, it does, Rasmus, thank you. Cool. Okay, the other classes, this is mostly done in back mounted, you know, either one tank on the back or two tanks like a twin set. You can even do it in a recreational jacket, BCD, or you can use a wing. That really doesn't matter. We, of course, try to emphasize the importance of doing it in twins, so you have two tanks on your back. If you don't want to do that, it is capable of doing in a single tank as well. But you can also do it in a side mount. So if you're not a side mount diver and interested in trying to side mount at the same time, you can actually extend the basics of exploration class with a day or two, and you can do it in side mount. So you'll have a side mount certification after you actually have attended this basic of exploration class. We'll talk more about side mount and what side mount actually is a little bit later on. I got the privilege to talk to you about cave diving and side mount diving later on today. We also, as a pretty new thing, have not the MCCR, that's not new, but ECCR. Later on I will tell you about the Prism, and there's a lot of other rebreathers here like the Poseidon and all the others. You can see them up here afterwards. But you can also get trained now in Inner Space Explorers on the ECCR. So that's how the structure is, but again, it all starts with the basics of exploration, okay?
Okay.
Next, you have something to add for classes?
No. It's okay for classes.
Okay.
Thank you, Rasmus. Just talk about the difference to other training agencies I talked about in the beginning. The one thing we have, you can make your, as Rasmus said, your classes in your configuration. You mustn't, or you needn't, to buy special manufacturer's equipment to take a class at our organization. What we have is a quality assurance, what means you, as a student, have to inform us about several issues at the training, about the structure of the training. It's a personal formulaire where you can fill out after that you completed your class, so we can see what's going on, and we have the possibility to instruct the instructors for doing it better the next time. So we always see on which stand are the students, on which stand are the instructors, and do we have to interact with them. We have critical skills. What's a critical skill? In a normal dive, or in a normal organization, you see, okay, let's put off the mask, put it on again, blew it out, and then all is okay. In a real dive, no one will come to you and say, okay, put down your mask, or you will lose your mask within the next 5 minutes. The mask will be gone, or the gas will be gone. And these are situations we will train within our classes. Not in the depth, not about 80 or 90 meters, but in the shallow water, so you can realize the feeling about occurring problems, how you react with them. Because you want to be a safe diver, and the most important thing to be a safe diver is to know how to realize and handle problems. A requalification is also a thing we have organized. There are divers making a class, performing a class, and then they will dive 1 year, 2 years, and they stop diving. And 5 years later, they think about, okay, let's do a 60, 70, 80 meter dive. I'm just certified for it, but we think that is dangerous. So we said, okay, if a student had a certification from our agency, he has to re-qualify after 3 years. And that's not only the students who have to re-qualify, also the instructors have to re-qualify. They will come, they will choose an instructor of their choice, and said, okay, let's make a training day. Let's see if all the skills you need for the dives or for the level you're certified are still there. For security, it is necessary that you have a good physical condition. About smoking, we don't have to talk at the technical diving. One thing, at a BOE class, it doesn't matter what you do, if you're a smoker, if you are not in a good condition. You can see how it works, and then you can make your own thoughts about changing the one or other thing in your life or in your equipment. It's your choice. We don't want to press you in a special scheme. So, one part we have set up this year too is the EcoDiver program. What's it? It's just a day of information. It's a day where we get information about ecological diving, how to dive, how to perform underwater, what to do with your configuration, how to store hoses so the regulator will not push on the bottom, and it's totally free of charge. So if you are interested in coming in touch with Inner Space Explorers, this would be the best possibility to hear something or see something about how we dive, how we configure equipment, and how we perform underwater. If you're interested in, just contact Spyros. He all knows about this program, and he can help you there. Why are you going to dive? Why do you make your education? There are students performing a class because they are happy to get a C card. I don't think it is necessary to make a course for a C card. If I decide to go diving, I want to see something, I want to realize special things underwater, I want to find new things. But mostly, you get your certification and then you are alone. You have no partner where you can say, okay, let's do some exploration projects, let's find something new, let's explore something. And therefore, ISE offers for his students the explorations in travel trips we do, so you can part of all the exploration themes we have. Rasmus, maybe you can talk about one exploration project?
Okay, yeah. Actually, later on today, when I'm going to talk to you about cave diving, I'm going to show you a little bit of exploration I did in Mexico just a few months ago, hiking out in the jungle. But the specific project Jochen is recommending me to telling about is the Viking project in Denmark. A few years ago, or over a long period of time, we have on the west coast of Jutland had a few wrecks in really shallow water, which people dove at. It's about 3 to 4 meters of depth, so everybody can dive there when the conditions are there. And nobody really knew what it was, so Akin came up with the idea, well, let's find out what it is. So we started investigating what these wrecks really were, and it turns out after spending a lot of time investigating, taking pictures, and looking on the internet, contacting museums, stuff like that, it was two Viking ships from I don't know when that actually turned into each other and sank at really shallow depth. But these divers over there has just been diving on it for a long period of time without knowing what it was. So exploration can be a lot of different things. Exploration can be deep, deep dives or deep, deep penetration in caves, but it can also be a lot of other things that everybody can join in on, like the Viking project in 3 or 4 meters of water, or like the Leros project, which Spyros maybe will tell you more about later, but where we're going here in April on some virgin wrecks. Virgin wrecks, that sounds naughty, but it's not. It just means it's wrecks that haven't been doped before down at the Leros Island. And you can actually be a part of this. You can be a part of coming down and dive almost untouched wrecks, find unbelievable stuff and see something that no one's seen before since World War II on these wrecks. And it's from 17 to 41 meters, so it's quite shallow. You just need to be Basics of Inspiration certified to join the trip. Am I right on this, Akim?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So again, come and ask more about the trip if you want to join in and dive some awesome wrecks. And there will be a lot of projects. Akim told you about the house project. You can be a part of that as well. He talked a little bit about one thing is diving, one thing is getting a certification and you go out. But I think the most of you in here knows the feeling that, yeah, where should we go this weekend? Oh, let's go where we were the last weekend. Okay, yeah, we go. But how many is really doing some cool stuff? How many is really doing what you really want to do? A lot of people is like, well, I want to go find a treasure chest. Well, cool, go look for it. But no one's go looking for it. But there's a lot of stuff out there. It doesn't have to be gold in the treasure chest. It can also be cool wreck diving. In October, I was with Akim in Sardinia, and we found a brand new wreck at 90 meters of depth. Nobody had doped before, and they just found out what wreck it was. We didn't even know at that time. So there's a lot of exploration to do out there. You just have to take the initiative to do so.
Yeah, thank you. You put a lot of money in your diving education. Open water diver, advanced open water diver. You started with technical diving. Some of you started with technical diving. It would be sad if you stopped diving because you have no more goals. And these exploration projects we have, what we offer, are goals where you can participate from. Questions? You don't have questions? Or you don't have to have questions? We will answer them later.
That is a procedure of questions and answers.
Yeah, as I said, you don't have to have questions now. Okay, thank you.